From 1960 to 1962, more than 14,000 youth left their families in Cuba, fearing indoctrination under the rising Fidel Castro regime to the United States with the aid of the Catholic Church. Parents were separated from their children in hopes of giving them a better future through the initiative Operation Pedro Pan. 41 of those Cuban boys would find themselves in Fort Wayne, a foreign land with nothing but the chance of opportunity and newfound freedom, an experience that would bond them for a lifetime out in 21 country.
All they want to do is succeed, but the government does not allow them.
They just want freedom.
They want to have the possibility of pursuit of happiness, which I believe everybody should be given that.
Nelson, Michael, and Pedro were only teens when they arrived to America.
The pilot said, "We're entering United States airspace. Welcome to the USA." Everybody clapped. Everybody said all kinds of wonderful words to Fidel Castro and his communist regime, you know. And everybody was so happy. I don't know how the airplane didn't explode.
Our parents, God bless them, they had the vision of what was going to take place in Cuba. They put forward the sacrifice, and I recall my mom telling me many times that hopefully those stars will be shining in Miami, and that every time that I will be feeling empty, sad, melancholic, to look at the stars, and she will be in Cuba looking at the same stars, and we will be touching each other.
I'm not sure if I can repeat my mother's words as I went in that plane. She was in tears and said, "Son, this is the best that we can do for you."
The sacrifice made by Nelson's mother perhaps saved him from spending much of his life in jail.
I was locked up in Cuba at the age of 16 for posting anti-Castro propaganda that simply said, "Cuba sí, Castro no." I was fortunate enough, they sprung me out. My friend, I ate some of the propaganda in the way to the police station. My friend wasn't as lucky. He still had a bunch of them in his pockets. He spent 18 years after I left Cuba in jail in Cuba for the same offense.
The boys soon graduated from Catholic Central High School, grew up, and created success through hard work. Years passed before they were finally reunited with their parents.
It was kind of troublesome for her to adjust herself. I'm not a little kid anymore, you know. I'm 23. I'm going and dating girls here and there. I own my own. I drive my own car. I work. Hey, you don't have to babysit me any longer, you know.
That takes courage. And that's one thing all our parents had, without any doubt, and plenty of love.
A selfless decision made decades ago bonded the Pedro Pan boys for the rest of their lives.
We are family.
What's there? It can never be broken.
But the unrest that remains in their home country over a half a century later is a reminder to them that help is still needed for those in Cuba.
I want people to remember what the Cubans are struggling with and what they are fighting for. Freedom is something that they need so they can succeed.
I believe this will be the third generation under the Castro regime, and God willing, they're showing what it requires. They want freedom, and our responsibility is to do whatever we can to make sure that that happens.
About a dozen of those who came to Fort Wayne through Operation Pedro Pan will gather this weekend with their families to celebrate the 60th anniversary. They plan to go out to dinner, tour several areas of Fort Wayne, and attend a special mass held by Bishop Kevin Rhodes. You can find Nelson, Michael, and Pedro's full story on our website. It's WPTA21.com.